Welcome back. We've already had a discussion about the basics of systems, their tangible components or physical components, and their intangible components or their non-physical components, which is often information and feedback. In this discussion, we're going to be talking about how systems behave, particularly behavior of systems over time. So to do that, I'm going to go back to our bathtub diagram, and I'm going to use this graph to illustrate how behavior changes over time. And we're going to talk about this in the context of two scenarios. First, a self-regulated scenario, which is the way most Earth systems operate. We don't manage Earth systems until we begin to influence them or mess them up. Most Earth systems operate in a state of dynamic equilibrium, and I'm going to give you an example of that here in just a minute with this bathtub example. But as we change Earth systems, then we get into managed environments, and these managed systems require some kind of desired outcome or goal or desired level, in the case the desired level of the volume of the bathtub, and that requires feedback. What kind of information do we need to know in order to make sure the bathtub is at the level we want, or the number of deer that are available in the woods is at the level that we want? And we also have to have controls, and so we're going to be talking about those in this context. I'm going to be talking about these two scenarios using basically three examples. We're going to drain the bathtub without control, we're going to fill the bathtub without control, and then we're going to fill it with management. So let's jump right into it. Let's start with draining the bathtub without control. The first thing we're going to need to do is have water coming in. So our input of water comes from our water source, which is another system that is disconnected right now. And this water comes in the pipe under pressure, but this valve, we're going to have to open this valve to allow water to flow into the tub, right? But we're not going to put a stopper in the bottom of the outlet right now, because we know that water is going to go out, and because we want to drain it without control, we're just going to turn this volume of water as wide as this outlet can handle the outflow of water. So this is basically draining the bathtub without control. So if you can imagine, at zero time, if this is volume in terms of gallons, and if this is 2 minutes, 4 minutes, 6 minutes, and eight of the water flowing into the bathtub, we're never going to see these levels of water rise to any number of gallons. It's going to stay flat all the way across this graph because it's going to drain and never fill up. So this would actually be filled gallons in the bathtub. All right. So that's our first example, draining without control. Now we want to fill it without control. So we're going to leave the water turned on, and we're going to put in the plug here in the tub. Let's make it a big plug so we can see it and put a little ring on it so we can pull it out when we need to, because we need a future control. Now in this case, we've got water going in. Water is slowly filling up the bathtub. So at 2 minutes, let's say we're going to have 10 gallons. At 4 minutes, we're going to have 20 gallons. And let's say right about here, let's say the volume of the bathtub is 30 gallons, okay? So that means that at about 6 or 8 minutes, depending on how long it takes to fill it up, let's just assume that at 6 minutes it's going to be 25, and at 8 minutes it's going to be 30. So our behavior over time is going to be a steep rising curve, and then it's going to do what? Well, since we have an outlet right here, water is going to go out this emergency pipe, which goes out this pipe, just like this. And this is what maintains the level of water in the bathtub. And so as long as the rate or the feedback of flow stays at a rate that is equivalent to the rate of outflow, this would be inflow, just like that, then we'll have what's called dynamic equilibrium. We'll just abbreviate that right there. And this is basically what nature does. Nature has internal feedback systems that allow for inputs and outputs to stay in balance. Now let's look at our third example of filling with management. Let's say that we now have a rate of inflow and a rate of outflow that maintains dynamic equilibrium, but in a human system, not a natural system, we may not want the bathtub to be that full. When we get in the water, it may cause water to spill out. So at this point, let's say we're looking for a desired goal of 25 gallons instead of our original unmanaged 30-gallon goal here. This is desired. Okay, so we're going to go for 25 gallons right across here. So at 25 gallons, how are we going to achieve that level and make sure that the water starts doing this over time and stays level? Well, in this case, that means we're going to have to turn off the water and we're going to have to stop the inflow once we reach this level in the tub. And that is a situation where we have created a specific outcome by controlling the inputs, by controlling the outputs, which means we control the inflow and the outflow. So in the future, we may want to go back up, but in this case, we don't need that emergency outlet, and it's not as useful to us because it's not part of our managed or controlled system. Now, the other point I want to emphasize as we close is that once you get a specific desired outcome, then your stock becomes a functional snapshot in time. And stocks are always individual snapshots of particular behavior frozen in a moment of time. And we'll talk about that more in a few minutes. So I hope this has given you a better understanding of how systems behave in self-regulated systems with dynamic equilibrium and in managed systems. And our goal is to help you understand how these dynamics interplay with human behavior at the end of the course. But between now and then, we're going to go very deeply into an understanding of ecology in the geosphere, the hydrosphere, the atmosphere, and the biosphere. And then we'll talk about that human element later.